I will attempt to keep old track, old, stiff, and retrograde, and get some pal to push me on, should resolution fade. For I must see black meikle pap against a starry sky, and watch the dawn from Lochnagar once more before I die. The golden plover whistled there before the fall of man, and you can hear the brittle croak of lonely ptarmigan. No heather there but boulders bare, and quartz and granite grit, and ribs of snow bleak, old and grey, as I remember it. And if I do not make the top, then sit me on a stone, some lichened rock among the screes, and leave me there alone. Yes, leave me there alone to hear where spout and buttress are, the breeze that stirs the little loch on silent Lochnagar.
Away ye gay landscapes, ye gardens of roses, and you let the minions of luxury rove. Restore me the rocks where the snowflake reposes, if still they are sacred to freedom and love. Yet Caledonia, beloved are thy mountains, round their white summits though elements war. Though cataracts foam, stead of smooth flowing fountains, I sigh for the valley of dark Lochnagar. There my young footsteps in infancy wandered, my cap was the bonnet, my cloak was the plaid. On chieftains departed, my memory pondered, as daily I strayed through the pine-covered glade. I sought not my home till the day's dying glory gave place to the rays of the bright polar star. For fancy was cheered by traditional story disclosed by the natives of dark Lochnagar. Years have rolled on, Lochnagar, since I left you. Years must elapse ere I see you again. Though nature of verdure and flowers has bereft you, yet still thou art dearer than Albion's plain. England, thy beauties are tame and domestic to one who has roved on the mountains afar. And it's all for the crags that are wild and majestic, the steep frowning glories of dark Lochnagar.